It's the best of times and the worst of times in Victoria at the moment. Let's catch up with Georgie Crozier, who's the Shadow Health Minister there. Thanks for joining us, Georgie. First up, the worst of times, these draconian new laws that Daniel Andrews was trying to get through Parliament. He's run into all sorts of problems, protests on the street, lawyers and human rights activists criticising them, along with the opposition, of course. Also, Adem Somyurek, the Labor Upper House MP, the disgraced Labor MP, saying he'd vote against them. Are they going to get through, do you think, or they're finished for good?
Well, Chris, it's a complete shambles. We don't know. The government has pulled the bill today after saying that it was an urgent bill on Tuesday. And, in fact, the leader of the government in the Upper House said, you know, the bill has been around for 20 days, we need to get on with it. That's what I intend to do. So it was urgent on Tuesday. Today they have pulled it. It is a complete and utter shambles.
The good news, though, is that Daniel Andrews has announced a massive relaxation of pandemic rules there. You know, now, obviously, this is the right thing to do because the vaccination rates are high and we've seen how it's working in New South Wales. But it seems he's just been pushed to do this by the political problems, perhaps to create a distraction. There's no reference to medical advice. All that's out the window. He's just saying open up. So it's kind of the right outcome, but for very spurious reasons.
Oh, well, look, every Victorian, I think, is really pleased that the restrictions are easing because we've done it so tough for so long. You know, the harshest restrictions, the worst outcomes, the longest lockdown city in the world. And so the restrictions easing tonight are welcome, but there's still so much confusion with some of these restrictions easing, Chris. I mean, I have to be vaccinated to go in and buy a pair of shoes, but I don't have to be vaccinated to visit somebody in an aged care facility where they're vulnerable. Residents.
There's a lot of confusion
around the school.
There's not a vaccine mandate for visiting old folks' homes?
No. You don't have to be vaccinated. It's recommended, you don't have to be vaccinated. So that's the confusion.
That's extraordinary.
It is extraordinary.
In aged care homes, even before COVID, you had to show proof of flu vaccination before you could visit.